Okay, good day. So this is our review lecture for the general engineering subjects. So we have probability, engineering economy, I physics and mechanics, and I the strength of materials. So since we have limited time, so daanan lang natin yung mga, let's say, some of the examples per subject. Then try natin i-maximize kung ilan yung masosolve natin for the given na 4 hours. Okay, so let's have our first example. Okay, example number one. Example number one is an example sa permutation. Okay, kung naalala pa natin yung formula for permutation. Okay, when it comes to permutation, this is about the arrangement of things, NPR. Nasa calculator lang din naman natin yan. Is equal to, okay, the n factorial divided by n minus r, okay, quantity factorial. Yun ay kung n is not equal to r, or kung hindi natin kukunin lahat ng objects, n, and pipili lang tayo ng smaller number than n. Like example is yung r, then i-arrange natin. But when it comes to the case that n is equal to r, ito yung i-arrange natin lahat ng objects. Okay, ang equivalent lang nito, we have the n pn is simply equal to the n factorial. Or basically, equal to n, okay, times n minus 1, times n minus 2, times n minus 3, and so on. So just a quick recall. Pero in some cases, hindi ganito kadali yung board exam natin. Okay, so parang hindi siya direct sub sa ating mga formula. Or direct, we cannot use directly yung mga nasa calculator natin. So, kailangan nyo lang i-observe yung mga limitations, okay, to solve the problem. So, again, for example number one, okay, in a certain city in the Philippines, all 7-digit telephone numbers begin with 350. How many telephone numbers may be assigned to that city if the last 4 digits should not begin or end with a 0? Nagiging mahirap ang permutation kapag nagkakaroon ng restrictions. Pero ang gagawin lang natin is, yun, sundin lang natin yung instruction ng problem. Okay, according to problem number 1, okay, so all okay, telephone numbers nagsisimula daw sa 350. So hindi na natin problema yan. Ang magiging problema lang natin is yung ay last 4 digits. Okay, so we have the last 4 digits. So, tingnan lang natin yung 4 positions na yon. Again, so yung i-apply lang natin dito is linear permutation. Okay, yun yung restriction ng problem. So, sundin lang natin yung problem. So, sabi niya, okay, so last 4 digits should not begin or end with a 0. So, ito yung first position and last position ng ating last 4 digits. So, dito, okay, bawal ang 0 sa una. Then, dito sa pinakadulo, bawal lang din ang 0. So, kung bawal ang 0 dito sa una, sino yung pwede? So, we have 1, 2, okay, 3, 4, 5, 6, okay, 7, 8, and 9. So, sila lang yung pwede. Mga non-zero numbers. So, ilan yan? So, obviously, we have 9. Okay, sa second position, pwede na yung 0. We have that as 0, 1, 2, 3, hanggang 9. So, ilan lahat yun? So, 9, nadagdagan lang ng 0, that will be 10. Then, the same lang dito sa ating third position, 0, 1, 2, 3, hanggang 9. So, that is also, okay, kung bibilangan natin yung mga digits na yun, or numbers na yun, that we have 10. Then, according ulit dito sa ating problem, should not end with 0. Bawal ulit yung 0 dito sa dulo. So, sino yung pwede? Okay, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Obviously, we have also 9. So, linear permutation. So, tulad nito, okay, kunin lang natin yung product okay, ng mga numbers na to. Okay, arranged in a line. So, kunin lang natin yung product. We have that as 9 times 10, okay, multiplied by 10, multiplied by 9. And we have number of ways. Our number of telephone numbers is equal to 8,100. So therefore, yung sagot natin sa item number 1 is okay, letter D. So that will be our solution kay problem number 1. Okay, so proceed naman tayo sa item number 2. So how many different ways can 3 blue, 2 red, 4 yellow bulbs are arranged in a string of Christmas lights with 9 sockets? So for item number 2, this is still under permutation. So we have, ang sabi niya dyan, we have 3 blue, okay, we have 2 red, and 4 yellow. So again, that is a total of 9 sockets. Pero ito yung case ng permutation na with identical elements. Identical elements or identical objects. So since i-arrange natin lahat ng objects, ito yung case ulit na all things. I-arrange natin lahat ng objects. So basically we have n permutation r is equal to the n factorial divided by the n minus r factorial. Pero sabi ko kanina, for the case na n is equal to r, ano lang yung equivalent nito? Yung npn is simply equal to the n factorial. So n factorial lang sana siya. Kaya lang, if we have the case with identical objects, anong gagawin? So this is n factorial to be divided by the number of identical objects, 1 factorial, multiplied by identical objects number 2 factorial, identical objects number 3 factorial, and so on. Let's say I sub n. So let's say we have yung 3 blue is our I1. We have 3 identical objects na blue. Then we have 2 identical bulbs na red. And 3 identical objects or bulbs na yellow. So bakit kailangan natin siyang i-divide? Okay, so what is the reason? Why should we divide this I1, I2, I3, and so on? So can we just observe? For example, we have 2 letter A's. Okay, for example, this letter A is to be placed as a second. The second letter A will be placed as a first. If you are to observe, nagkaroon ba ng pagbabago sa arrangement? So, hindi. Hindi yan i-consider na may changes sa arrangement. We have still 2A. Yun yung mga chances na ika-cancel natin. That's why i-divide natin. So, again, we have a total of 9 bulbs. So, we have this as 9 factorial. Okay, this is divided by 3 identical blue bulbs. Then multiplied by, we have 2 identical red bulbs. Multiplied by 4 identical yellow bulbs. So we have, the number of arrangements now equal to. So we have that as 9 factorial. Okay, to be divided by 3 factorial. Okay, multiplied by 2 factorial. Then multiplied by 4 factorial. So we have that as 1,260 arrangements. So again, kindly observe if the given, kung meron tayong mga identical objects. Okay, so we need to divide them. So para ma-cancel out yung chances na magkatabi yung the same objects. So that will be our solution kay problem number 2. Okay, so we proceed sa problem number 3. Okay, so for problem number 3, so 3 people, A, B, and C, kayo rode in a minibus that has 6 vacant seats on each side. In how many ways can they be seated if A insists on sitting at the right side of the minibus? So again, nagiging mahirap lang yung ating problem kapag meron siyang restriction. So, ang i-apply lang ulit natin dito is linear permutation. So let's say sa ating minibus, so we have 6 seats on each side. So we have 6 seats dito sa left side, tapos okay, dito naman sa right side, 6 din. Yan. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So meron tayong tatlong tao o yung 3 subjects natin. So dun lang tayo mag-focus. So we have A, B, and C. Okay, so for A, B, and C, so kunin lang natin yung possible number of ways. Yan. So, ilan ba yung ipoposition natin na tao? So, we have 3. So, we have kay A, tapos okay, kay B, then C. Again, this is under kay linear permutation. So, sabi niya, okay, or yung restriction, okay, the restriction of the problem, in how many ways can they be seated if okay, we have A insists, okay, seating, insists on sitting at the right side. So, therefore, ilan yung option ni A? So, sa yung una nating ipoposition. Ilan yung option ni A kung ang gusto lang ni A ay gusto niya lang umupo dito sa may right side. So, obviously, kung sa right side lang siya, mamimili lang siya sa right side, okay, we have 6 seats kay A. So, for example, okay, lagay na natin si A dito. Yan. So, nilagay ko na lang si A dyan. Ilan yung options ni B? Ay, di ba, we have a total of 12 seats. Kung 12 seats yan at nakaupo na si A, ilan yung pagpipilian ni B? So, obviously, we have that as 11. Ah, di ba? So, 12 minus 1 kasi nakaupo na si A, 11. Okay, for example, nandito na si B. Okay, kahit saan naman, walang restriction kay B. Pwede siyang umupo sa left or right. Kung nakaupo na si A at saka si B, ilan yung options ni C? So, kung nakaupo na yung dalawa, we have 12 seats. Okay, obviously, 10 na lang ang option ni C. Then, kunin natin yung product, linear permutation. 6 times 11 is 66. Okay, times 10 is equal to okay, 660. So, therefore, yung sagot natin sa number 3 is okay, letter A. So, linear permutation lang yan. Pero yun, sundan lang natin yung restriction ng problem. Okay, so and then we continue to okay, item number 4. How many permutations can be made out of the letters of the word engineering? So still under a linear permutation, okay, the same case. Okay, so I hope meron na kayong idea since this is the same case as item number 2. Permutations, permutation with okay, identical elements or identical objects. May magkakaparehong objects dun sa mga i-arrange natin. So, how to compute for the number of ways or number of arrangements kapag meron tayong identical objects? So, ito ulit yung case ng all kay all things. So, since i-arrange natin lahat ng letters ng word na okay, engineering. So, basically, how many letters yan? By the way, so, kapag with identical objects, okay, arranging all things, ito yung n factorial. Pero kapag meron kang identical objects, okay, divided by I sub 1 factorial, okay, I sub 2 factorial, I sub 3 factorial n, so on. Up to okay, I sub n. So, ilan ba lahat yung letters okay, of the word engineering? So, yun yung ating n. Ilan lahat yan? So, we have 3, I 6, 9, so we have 11. So, tama ba? Is that 11? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. We have 11 letters. So, let's have our I sub 1. Sabihin ko na lang na yung ating I sub 1 ay yung mga letter E. Ilan yung letter E natin? We have I 3. Tapos, ilan ulit yung letter N? So, sabihin ko siya yung ating I sub 2, we have also I 3. Then, letter G, how many letter G? So we have dot s, ii sub 3, we have 2. Ilan ulit yung letter I, or capital letter I? So we have, okay, capital letter I, we have, okay, 2. Sabihin na natin siya yung ating I sub 4. Okay, this is, okay, 2. Then, yun lang yata. So we have 3 letter E, 3 letter N, 2 letter G, N, okay, 2 letter I. So, kung isasama kasi natin yung nag-iisang letter R, so pwede mong ilagay yan as I sub 5. That is the same as 1 lang naman kasi yun. Okay? So, mag-substitute lang tayo. So, we have this as okay, 11 factorial. All letters are to be arranged. Okay, divided by I sub 1 is 3 factorial. So, multiplied by I sub 2 is 3 factorial. Then, I sub 3 is okay, 2 factorial. Then, I sub 4, we have 2 factorial. And this is equal to, we have that as 11 factorial, then divided by okay, 3 factorial, multiplied by 3 factorial, then multiplied by 2 factorial, and multiplied by 2 factorial. So, we have that as 277,200. So 277,200 ay possible arrangements. So sa choices natin ay that will be ay letter B kay item number 4. So that will be our solution kay problem number 4. Again, permutation kay with identical objects. Okay, arranging all things with identical objects. Okay, then we have item number 5. So, how many circular arrangements can be made okay, from 7 different objects if all are taken at a time? So, for item number 5, okay, ito naman yung circular permutation. So, for circular permutation, mas practical lang na i-memorize nyo lang naman. Kapag linear, okay, paano ulit yung linear kapag all things? Kung kukunin natin lahat ng objects, then i-arrange natin. Yun yung n factorial kapag linear. Kapag circular, bawasan nyo lang ng isa, n minus 1 factorial. So, the equivalent of our n for this problem, ay ang given is 7. So, therefore, our circular permutation or circular arrangement of 7 different objects is 7 minus 1 factorial. And that is equal to? Okay, we have that as 7 minus 1 factorial. Kung mahaba-haba lang siguro yung time na given, so pwede nating explain kung paano naging n minus 1. So we have that as okay, 720. So yung sagot natin is 720. Okay, sa choices natin, that is, we have kay letter B. So yung solution natin, kay item number 5. So bonus question lang minsan ito kapag lumalabas sa board exam. Okay, circular permutation, n minus 1 factorial. Okay, then we proceed sa number 6. So sa number 6 is an example ng probability problem. Basically, ang probability is the desire ay divided by kay the total possible outcomes. So, okay, minsan yung desire is minsan gumagamit tayo dito ng permutation. Yan, permutation or minsan gumagamit tayo ng kay combination. So the same lang din naman sa kay total number of outcomes. So usually sa desire ay mas mataas yung kanyang restriction. So, yung total naman, ay most of the time, less restriction siya. So, mas mahirap minsan kunin yung numerator kesa dito sa okay, denominator. So, again, it's either gagamit tayo ng permutation or ay combination. Pero in some cases, ay pwede rin naman, ay other than permutation, combination, pwede rin lang din naman yung simpleng problem sa probability. na masosolve lang natin by simply ay direct ay counting. Okay, so let's have our example ay number 6. So I think this is more on ay direct counting lang tayo. So one box contains 4 cards ay numbered 1, 3, 5, and 6. So meron tayong box ay the numbers we have 1, 3, 5, and 6. Okay, another box contains 3 cards ay numbered 2, 4, and 7. So this is 2, 4, and 7. So ano yung required? So one card is drawn from each box. Find the probability that the sum is an even number. So parang hindi lang siya simple yung probability problem. Okay, gagamit tayo ng konting concept ng algebra. Okay, so we have sa first box, ano yung mga numbers? 1, 3, 5, and 6. Sa second box, yung mga numbers, 2, 4, and 7. So ano ba yung mga conditions na nagkakaroon tayo ng sum ng dalawang numbers na magiging even? So paano siya magiging even? Okay, so inspect lang natin. Okay, number 1. Okay, so take note na ang even number plus an even number is always even. Yun yung isang case na i-consider natin. So, ano yung example? Parang we have 4 plus 8 is equal to 12. Laging ganun. Even plus even is always even. Then the next possible case, I take note that an odd number plus an odd number is always even. Ano naman yung mga example natin? So let's say odd number, let's say 3 plus odd number is 5. 3 plus 5 is equal to 8. So yun, odd number plus odd number is always even. And ano pa yung isa pa? Take note that an odd number plus an even number is always an... Okay, it is always an odd number. So yun, maglagay lang tayo ng example. Okay, odd number, let's say 3, plus even number, let's say 4, and that is equal to 7, which is an odd number. So therefore, ano yung mga cases na i-consider natin? Okay, ang required sa problem na to is kailangan natin ng even. The sum is, okay, the sum is even. So therefore, we have two cases. So, yun yung case number 1. Ito yun, even plus even is always even. And case number 2, odd plus odd is always even. So, sila lang yung i-consider natin since ang required ng problem, the desire is even. Okay, so gawa natin ng equation. Ito yung ating okay, case. We have case number 1. Okay, again, ito yung even plus even. Okay, so probability is the desired outcomes or desired outcomes okay, divided by the total possible outcomes. Or again, okay, pwedeng gumamit ng permutation combination or in some cases, pwedeng direct counting lang. So let's say this is P1. Ano yung probability na even ang mabubunot natin sa first box. Again, ito yung first box, ito yung ating second box. So, ang total natin dito sa first box is equal to 4. There are 4 numbers. And ang total natin dito sa second box is 3. We have 3 numbers. Okay, balikan ko lang. Ano yung probability na even ang mabubunot natin sa box? Number 1. So, sino ba yung mga even dito? We have only 1. That is 6. So, that is 1 out of 4. So, that is 1 over 4. Then, multiplied by, dito na tayo sa second box. Ano yung probability na even ang mabubunot? So, sino yung mga even numbers dito? We have 2 and 4. So, dalawa. So, therefore, we have that as 2. Out of 3. We have two out of 3 na even numbers sa second box. So we simplify. So that is 2 over. Yan. So we have that as 1/4. Then multiplied by I 2 over 3. So this is, I think, 1 over 6. So this is 1 over 6. Yun yung ating case number 1. Then case number 2. Okay, case number 2 natin, ito yung odd number. Okay, odd number plus an odd number. So, odd plus odd is always even. So, sabihin ko, ito yung ating probability, number 2. So, ano yung probability na odd number yung mabubunot natin? So, we have that as 1, 3, and 5. So, tatlo sila. So, therefore, we have that as 3 out of, a total of 4. Then, dito na tayo sa ating second box. So, ilan yung odd number? Yun lang yung 7. So, 1 out of a total of 3. So, this is the same as 1 over 3. So, cancel lang natin yung 3. Probability number 2 is simply a 1/4. So, kung gusto nating kunin yung total probability na yung mabubunot natin na one number for each box is an even number, the total probability is probability number 1, yung ating case 1, plus probability number 2, case number 2. So we have that as 1/4 kay plus ano, baliktad. So we have that as P1 is 1 over 6 plus 1 over 4. So total probability is equal to 1 over 6 plus 1/4 is equal to 5 over 12. So ang sagot natin sa problem number 6 is 5 over 12. That will be a letter A. So we need to inspect minsan sa probability problems kung meron tayong more than one possible cases. Okay, so problem number 7 tayo. So for problem number 7, okay, this is an example for a combination. So, sa calculator natin, we have that as the N CR, N combination R, which is equal to, ang equivalent niya is equal to the N factorial divided by kay N minus R factorial times R factorial. Okay, so yun yung parang pagkakaiba lang niya dun sa formula ng permutation. But again, nasa calculator lang din naman natin yan. So, i-recall lang natin. Diba, when it comes to the permutation, so permutation, ito yung N PR is equal to the N factorial divided by N minus R factorial. So basically, ang relation ng dalawa is equal to, okay, ano ba yung pinagkaiba lang nila? That is the same as NPR divided by R factorial. So, ang tanong minsan, kailan tayo gagamit ng combination? Kailan tayo gagamit ng permutation? So, commonly, ang ginagamit na words or yung clue natin pagdating sa combination, ginagamit yung term na select, and at the same time, or minsan, ginagamit naman yung term na ay na choose. Okay, kapag ginamit yung term na select or choose, okay, that is a combination. And take note, when it comes to a combination, lagi siyang not all things. Okay? So, unlike sa permutation, madalas siya na all things. Pero pwede naman, pagdating kasi sa permutation, kay pwedeng not all things. So, pwedeng not all things, okay, or pwede rin naman na all things. Pero pagdating sa combination, it is always not all things. Kasi take note na yung combination, kapag gumamit ka si class ng ano, ng combination of all things, ang combination ng all things is always equal to 1. So take note na yung ating n, if n is equal to r, or basically n combination n, it is always equal to 1. Kaya walang combination of all things kasi ang sagot mo doon is 1. Okay, yun lang naman yung mga clues natin kung kailan gagamit ng combination or kailan naman gagamit ng ay permutation. Okay, so let's have problem number 7. Ang sabi niya, a company will hire 7 men and 4 women. In how many ways can the company choose from 9 men and 6 women who are qualified for the positions? So, take note, ang ginamit niya na word is ay choose. And one thing more, minsan dito sa permutation, combination, and probability, kaya kapag ginamit niyo yung term na or, ang gawin niyo is you are to add. Kapag ginamit naman niyo yung term na n, you are to okay, multiply. Okay, so additional clues okay, sa kung ano yung gagawin pagdating sa permutation and okay, combination. So again, okay, a company will hire 7 men and 4 women. So ilan ba yung pagpipilian? Okay, pipili sila from 9 men and 6 women. So we have 9 men. Ito yung item number 7 natin. We have 9 men and 6 women. So ilan yung pipiliin? Mag-hire tayo dito ng 7 men and okay, we have 4 women. Again, ang ginamit na term is choose, then we have n. Yun. So 7 men and 4 women. So let's have the number of okay, the number of ways. So for the number of ways, so unahin natin dun sa men. So we have 9 men, ilan yung kukunin? So combination 7. Tapos again, ang ginamit na term is n, so kailangan nating mag-multiply. Okay? So ang ginamit na term is n, so mag-multiply tayo. So we have that as 6 women, ilan yung kukunin? 4. So we have 6 combination 4. Yun yung ating total number of ways. We have and this is 9, okay, combination of 7. So times 6 combination of 4. So you have that as 540 number of ways. So yung sagot natin sa item number 7, 540, okay, that will be my letter. Okay, that's letter D. Okay, so let's have item number 8. Okay, this is a dice problem. So if a pair of dice is toss, find the probability of getting a total of 6 or 12. Okay, so when it comes to the dice problem, ay kapag singular siya, ito yung die. So kapag more than 2, 2 or more, yun na yung dice. So for a given die, alam naman natin na cube yun, di ba? So we have dots. So parang number of dots is 1 to 6. So yung total probability ay na makuha tayo ng isang value sa isang dice is 1 out of kapag cube, ilan yung faces ng cube? We have 6. So kapag 2 dice, ang gagawin lang natin kay per problem number 8 is okay, gawa lang tayo ng mga boxes kay na 6 by 6. Ayan, so since when it comes to two dice, diba, ito yung probability sa isang die is 1 over 6 okay, per pace. So kapag two dice, okay, gawa lang tayo ng mga boxes na ay 6 by 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So pababa naman, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So, yung possible outcomes is okay, the number of this boxes. So, basically, ay 6 by 6. So, ang total natin dito is 6 by 6. So, a total of ay 36. So, balikan lang natin yung ating tanong. Ang required dito is getting a sum of 6. Ay, getting a sum of 6 or 12. So, again, ang ginamit na term is or. So, magsasum up tayo. Okay, so, ay, i-shade lang natin yung mga portion kung saan pwedeng magkaroon ng sum na 6. So, yung una is, okay, we have the sum of, ay, sum of 6. So, ano yun? We have, ay, 1 plus 5. So, yun yung box na to. We have 1 plus 5 is 6. We can have it as 2 plus 4. Okay, yun. 2 plus 4 is also 6. We have 3 plus, okay, 3 plus 3. Pwede rin naman na 4 plus 2. Or pwede rin naman na 5. Okay, the 5 plus 1. So, ilan yung sum of 6 natin? Ilan ba yung shaded area, shaded boxes? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, 5 yun. Then, yung next requirement is okay, the sum of 12. Obviously, ito yung maximum score lang kapag 2 dice. So, sum of 12, okay, obvious naman yun. 6 plus 6 lang yun. Wala nang iba. So, ang sum of 12 natin is only okay, 1 box. Okay, out of this, okay, 36 boxes. So, ang probability is basically equal to the desire divided by the total possible outcomes. So, ang ginawa kasi kanina is, or ang ginamit na term is or, kaya mag-a-add tayo. Okay, ilan yung sum of 6? We have that as 5. Ginamit na term is or, kaya plus. Sum of 12 is 1. Okay, total possible outcomes is okay, 36 kapag, okay, kapag 2 dice. Okay, yung probability natin is equal to 6 over 36 or simply 1 over 6. So, 1 over 6 sa number 8. Okay, we have that as letter D ulit. So, yun yung solution natin sa problem number 8. Okay, so sa number 9 naman tayo. If 6 coins are tossed simultaneously, so find the probability that they will just have 3 heads. Okay, so for item number 9, ito yung probability for the coin. So, alam naman natin sa coin, okay, we have 2 faces. Okay, one is the head, the other is the tail. So, ano yung probability na magiging head siya? That is 1 half. Probability na tail is also okay, 1 half. Okay, but this is applicable only kapag ang pinag-uusapan is ay 1 coin. So, what about kapag ito, yung case natin, okay, we have 6 coins. So, marami. So, kapag marami yung coins or parang multiple events, pero ia-assume natin na constant yung probability per coin. So, constant pa rin or expected pa rin na 0.5 or 1 half pa rin na head, 1 half pa rin na tail kahit marami sila. Okay, kapag multiple events, or ito, multiple samples, how to compute for the probability? The probability is equal to, ay, gagamit tayo ng combination, n combination r, kay p raised to r, then q raised to n minus r. Wherein yung ating p at q, sabihin natin na yung p is probability to pass, mangyayari siya, plus yung Q naman is probability to fail na hindi siya mangyayari is always equal to 1. Okay? So, mangyayari, probability na mangyayari plus yung probability na hindi mangyayari is always equal to 1. Okay? So, yung sa example natin dito, Okay, the number of samples or number of coins is equal to 6. Yun yung ating n. And ang gusto lang ng problem na to is we have 3 heads. So let's have r is equal to 3. Ano yung probability? Okay, nung gusto nating mangyari, okay, dapat head siya. So alam naman natin, okay, kapag probability na head for coin is 1 half. E ano yung probability na hindi siya head? Okay, that is yung Q natin. Okay, this is also, that is also 1 half. Okay, ito naman yung probability na ito ay, okay, tail. Ayan, so we may substitute. So let's have the probability. Okay, the probability is equal to, mula sa 6 na coins, kukuha tayo ng 3, and yung 3 na yan, it should be expected na yung outcome niya is maging head. Probability na head is 1 half raised to, ilan yung gusto nating maging head? We have 3. So ano yung probability naman na tail siya or fail? That is 1 half. So we have 6. Kung yung 3 is head, automatically, yung 3 dapat is a tail. Yun yung n minus r. Or basically, so 6 minus 3. So kung 3 yung head, automatic na 3 yung tail. So computing for the probability is equal to, we have 6 combination 3 okay, multiplied by 1 half, or that is the same as 0.5 raised to 3. Tatlong heads kay 0.5 raised to 6 minus 3. So, tatlo rin yung tail. Or, edit lang natin. It should be 0.5. So, we have that as the total probability is called 5 over 16. So, sa ating choices, so we have that as 5 over 16. Problem number 9 is letter A. Okay, so we proceed sa problem number 10. And ito na yung start natin sa example sa engineering economy. So, item number 10 is an example ng simple interest. Okay, so how do we compute for the value ng simple interest? Okay, interest is equal to the present amount or principal amount, interest rate, times the number of interest period. Wherein yung interest period natin na n na to should be in terms of years. So we have two types of simple interest. Yung una is the ordinary. So ordinary naman yung given dito. So pagdating sa ordinary simple interest, okay, medyo iba lang yung gagamitin natin dito na parang period. So, when it comes to ordinary simple interest, ang equivalent ng 1 year is equal to 360 days lang. Okay, when it comes to ordinary simple interest, 1 year is 360 days. So, which means, ang equivalent lang ng 1 month ay 30 days. So, wala siyang pakialam kung 30 days, 31 days, 28 or 29 days yung buwan. Basta per month, it is 30 days. Or minsan, ginagamit ito as the banker's calendar. So, sa banker's calendar, okay, 30 days lang per month. Then, yung isa naman is yung, okay, we have the exact simple interest. So, pagdating sa exact simple interest, okay, kinoconsider natin na 1 year is 365 days. So, bibilangin natin yung exact number of days kapag exact simple interest. So, 365 days kapag non-leap year. Well, equal naman ito sa 366 days kapag leap year. Yun lang naman yung pagkakaiba nung dalawang simple interest natin. So, we have ordinary and exact simple interest. Okay, so let's have problem number 10. Sabi niya dito, so find the ordinary simple interest on 1,000 pesos for 8 months and 20 days at an interest rate of 10%. So let's list down lang muna natin yung mga given. So, pag ginamit yung term minsan na deposit or oh, wala naman siyang sinabing deposit dito, pero kung ito yung ating initial value o yung ating present amount or the principal amount is equal to ay 1,000 pesos. Number of interest periods, ang sabi niya dito is we have 8 months, okay, then plus 20 days. So, gawin na natin siyang in terms of days, n is equal to 8. So, sinabi niya na ordinary. So, kapag ordinary simple interest, 1 month is 30 days. So, 8 times 30 plus 20. A total number of 8 times 30 is 240 plus 20 is equal to 260 and 260 days. Tapos yung given na interest rate ay equal sa ay 10%. So hinahanap lang natin yung interest. So more likely or parang more on direct sub lang tayo dito. We have the interest is equal to the present amount, interest rate, number of interest period. So a present amount of 1,000 kay multiplied by yung given na rate is 10%, we have 0.10. So number of interest period is 260 days. So this is multiplied by 200 ay 60 days. So take note na nasa ordinary simple interest tayo. Yung n kailangan lang natin siyang gawing a year. So this is multiplied by ang conversion factor natin. We have 1 year is to ay ordinary simple interest 360 days. Ayun lang yung ating equation for the simple interest. So computing for this interest is equal to we have 1,000 ay multiplied by 0.10. Tapos we have 260. Convert lang natin sa year. Ordinary simple interest, 1 year is to 360 days. So we have that as 72.22. So 72.22 pesos. So check natin sa choices. Okay, we have 72.22. That will be a letter A for problem number 10. Again, problem number 10 is an example ng ordinary simple interest sa engineering economy. Okay, so proceed tayo sa number 11. So number 11 is an example ng compound interest. So for compound interest, how do we compute for the future amount? Future amount formula yung meron tayo. We have the future amount is called the present amount or principal amount. Okay, multiplied by 1 plus the effective rate of interest raised to n. Pero in some cases, when it comes to compound interest, hindi lang siya compounded annually. So meron tayong several numbers of compounding. So kapag compounded annually, we have yung m natin is equal to 1. Kapag compounded monthly, kay the value of m is equal to monthly we have 12 months. So kapag compounded quarterly, kay we have the number of or the value of m is equal to 4. Ano pa ba yung mga possible number of compounding? So monthly and annually, monthly, quarterly, pwede rin naman yung semi-annually. So kapag semi-annually, the value of m is semi-annually twice a year, the value of m is equal to 2. So yun yung saan ba natin gagamitin yung value ng m na to? So when it comes to the effective rate of interest ay so ay na rin yung ginagamit natin kapag ang term na ginamit is the effective that is the effective rate or the same lang siya kapag compounded annually. Okay, well we have the sa ibang reference ay magkakaiba yung letter na ginagamit pero dito gamitin natin is J. Yung J naman yung value ng let's say this is the nominal rate. Yan. So what is the equivalent of I in terms of J? Or we have I, the effective rate, is the nominal rate divided by the number of compounding. So again, depende kung annually, ay monthly, quarterly, or semi-annually. Kaya minsan, yung formula natin dito sa future amount ng compound interest is, okay, ina-expand natin yan depende kung ano yung compounding. So we have the future amount is equal to the present, okay, multiplied by 1 plus, okay, ano equivalent ng I? So the I is equal to the J divided by M, the nominal rate divided by the number of compounding. So raised to N. Pero yung N na to, kailangan natin i-multiply ng M. So for example, if it is compounded quarterly, so sa isang taon, may apat na quarters. Kaya kailangan natin ng multiplier na M dito sa number of compounding periods. So we have the N times M. Okay, so let's have problem number 11. Okay, sabi niya dito sa problem number 11, at the birth of a child, what amount should his father invest in order to provide the child with 25,000 pesos at the age of 21 years if money earns 4.38% compounded quarterly? So list down natin yung mga given. So this is for problem number 11. So hinahanap natin dito yung i-invest. So magkano raw yung i-invest? So therefore, we are looking for the principal or the present amount. So makakapag-provide siya ng future amount of 25,000 pesos. Sabi niya dito, that is after 21 years. So it is compounded. It is compounded quarterly, 4.38% compounded quarterly. So we have that as the nominal rate. We have this is 4.38% percent, it is compounded kay quarterly. Okay, so far, yun yung ating mga given. Okay, paano natin i-compute yung the present amount? So kapag compounded quarterly, the number of compounding period per year is equal to 4. Or pwede rin natin i-convert ito yung 4.38% into decimal. So basically, what is 3 over 8? 0.375. So we have that as okay, so 4. Okay, so this is 4.375%. Ayan, so direct sub tayo. Right, so let us compute for the present amount. So we have the future amount is equal to the present amount multiplied by 1 plus I raised to n. So ito lang yung ginagamit natin kapag compounded annually. Pero again, it is compounded quarterly, kaya kailangan nating expand. We have the future amount is equal to the present amount multiplied by 1 plus the j over m I raised to n times m. So, mag-substitute tayo. We have 25,000, the future amount, is equal to the present amount, okay, multiplied by 1 plus our quarterly rate, compounded quarterly, we have 4.375 or 0.04375, okay, divided by quarterly, divided by 4. So, ito ay i-invest for a period of 21 years. Pero sa 21 years na yon, kada isang taon, may apat na quarters. Kaya kailangan nating i-multiply to, multiplied by 4. So, computing for the present amount is now equal to, okay, so this is 25,000 is equal to, let's say, alpha x. So, mag-shift solve lang ako. 1 plus 0.04375 compounded quarterly, so divided by 4. This is good for 21 years, pero kada isang taon, may apat na quarters. So, shift solve lang ako. So, this is 10,025.32. So, we have the present amount, okay, 10,025.32. 32 pesos yun yung kailangan nating i-invest ngayon para makapag-provide ng 25,000 pesos after 21 years. So sa choices natin for number 11, it is letter A. So yun yung solution natin sa example natin for a compound interest ay item number 11. So for number 12 is an example ng annuity. So konting intro lang tayo or recall for annuity. So annuity ay equal payments or equal amount of payments tapos equal din yung kanilang intervals. So ang importante lang sa annuity, dapat alam lang natin yung location ng present amount and the future amount. So let's have example or konting intro. Yan. So for example, we have 4 payments. So equal amounts yung mga yan, tapos equal din yung kanilang interval. So saan matatagpuan yung present amount? So present amount is always on the 0. Or basically, we can have it as one step backwards from your first payment. While yung future amount naman ng isang annuity ay matatagpuan sa tapat ng last payment. So kung given lang sana yung, or mas marami sana ng given time, we can derive this formula kay para sa present amount and future amount. But for this lecture, yun, ibibigay ko na lang muna for the meantime. So ang present amount is equal to the annuity kay multiplied by 1 minus 1 plus I raised to negative n. This is I divided by I. Ayun yung formula ng ating present amount for annuity. So for the future amount naman, equal to the annuity, then multiplied by the quantity, we have 1 plus I raised to n minus 1 divided by I. So ito yung mga formula natin for annuity, both for present and future. So take note na tulad dun sa ating compound interest, pwede rin na mag-iba yung kanilang compounding period. So pwedeng compounded annually, monthly, quarterly, semi-annually, and so on. So take note na kapag ganun, ang equivalent pa rin ng ating I is the nominal rate J divided by M. So let's have our example, number 12. So sa number 12, what is the present value of a 3-year annuity paying 3,000 pesos at the end of each year with interest at 8% compounded annually? So kung compounded annually lang naman siya, I think more on direct sub lang tayo for this example. So for number 12, ganun pa rin yung dapat yung ginagawa. Okay, list down first the given. So we have, ang hinahanap dito is the present amount. Yun, so kung magkano yung present amount. So 3-year annuity, the value of n is equal to 3 years. Tapos, the amount of that annuity is equal to 3,000 pesos. Yung given na rate is equal to 8%. 8%. So, ang lagi nyong i-observe pagdating sa annuity is yung mode nung dalawang values na to. Yung payment at saka yung rate. Dapat pareho. So far, ang given is 8% compounded annually. So, annually siya. Yung ating given rate, it is annually. So basically, the value of M dyan is simply equal to 1. Tapos, yung payment natin is at the end of each year, which means annually din yung payment. Kailangan the same. Okay, so kailangan pareho. So again, so for problem number 12, direct sub lang tayo. And we are looking for the present value. So mag-substitute tayo sa formula na to. We have the present amount is equal to annual payment is 3,000. Okay, multiplied by 1 minus 1 plus 0.08. This is raised to, good for 3 years, raised to negative 3. Okay, divided by 0.0, okay, 0.08. Yeah, so, computing for the present value. So this is 3000, okay, multiplied by okay, 1 minus, okay, 1 plus 0.08. This is good for 3 years. Okay, divided by 0.08. So we have that as 7731.29. So this is equal to 7731.29 pesos. Okay, so ang sagot natin sa number 12 will be ay letter B, 7731.3. So yun yung example natin, first example natin for annuity, problem number 12. Okay, next, so we have problem number 13. So problem number 13 is also under annuity, pero special occasion ng annuity, kaya na kung tawagin natin is the perpetuity. So perpetuity, okay, annuity pa rin naman siya, pero yung value ng n niya, or the number of interest period, is equal to infinity. Or hindi natin alam kung kailan siya matatapos. So, since hindi natin alam kung kailan matatapos yung payment, present amount lang yung okay, baka compute natin. So, the present amount is equal to the annuity okay, divided by i. So, depende ulit kung iba yung kanyang compounding. So, kung hindi siya compounded annually, okay, we have that is the annuity divided by the j okay, divided by m. So, simply again, yung equivalent ng i natin ay equal to okay, the j divided by the m. So, yung formula nito is nanggaling lang din naman sa present amount formula. Iset nyo lang yung n equal to infinity. And ito yung magiging kay, result. So, for problem number 13, sabi niya, find the present value of perpetuity of 15,000 pesos payable semi-annually. So, yung annuity natin is equal to 15,000. This is paid semi-annually. So, if money is worth 8%, kay compounded quarterly. So, that is a nominal rate. We have J is equal to 8%. It is I compounded quarterly. So again, since this is still under annuity, ano yung kailangan yung i-observe sa mga ganitong problem? Kailangan yung i-observe yung mode ng payment at saka yung mode ng rate. So take note na yung payment natin is nagbabayad tayo semi-annually. Pero yung given na rate is quarterly. So, take note na hindi pwedeng i-apply ang rate na quarterly sa bayad na semi-annually. So, anong gagawin doon? So, kapag nagkataon na magkaiba sila, so, gagamit tayo dyan ng equivalent rates. So, paano mag-convert? So, kailangan nating i-convert yung rate na quarterly. Ano equivalent rate niya kapag naging semi-annual? So, again, kailangan semi-annual dahil yung payment natin is okay, semi-annually. So, by equivalent rates, ito yung 1 plus the J1 over M1 raised to M1 is equal to okay, the 1 plus okay, the J sub 2 okay, divided by M sub 2 okay, raised to M sub 2. So, ito yung parang conversion natin. So, from one rate to another. So, again, kailangan natin i-convert yung rate na quarterly, gagawin natin semi-annually. So, ilagay ko na lang na yung ating J1, siya yung para dito sa semi-annually. Yung given na 8% is our J sub 2, 8%. And okay, yung ating M1, what is the value of M kapag semi-annually? Twice a year, value of M1 is equal to 2. Then yung ating M2, what is the value of M kapag quarterly? So quarterly, 4 times a year. So 4 quarters a year. Ayan, so mag-convert tayo. This is, we have 1 plus J1 semi-annually. Okay, that is divided by 2, okay, raised to 2. is equal to, we have 1 plus j sub 2 is 0.08% or 0.08 divided by 4 I raised to raised to 4. So yung rate na to, J1, this is already a rate under semi-annual. So siya yung gagamitin natin dahil yung payment is semi-annual. Okay, let's have that value. Okay, so we have that as 1 plus 0.08, okay, divided by 4. So this is raised to 4. Then raised to 1 over 2. Then minus 1. Then times 2. So we have that as, okay, so times 100 para percent. So we have that as 8.08%. So we have 8.08%. So dapat ito yung gagamitin natin kasi yung payment natin is semi-annual. A semi-annual rate for a semi-annual payment. Dapat ganun. Okay, yun lang naman yung common trick na panglito kapag annuity yung problem. Yung magkaiba yung mode ng payment at saka yung mode ng given rate. So ngayon, okay, I think pwede na tayong mag direct sub. So we are just looking for the value of the present amount. So present amount is simply equal to A over I, but since it is compounded semi-annually, annuity divided by the J divided by M. So present amount natin is semi-annual payments is 15,000 divided by ano yung semi-annual rate natin? 8.08% or 0.0808. It is compounded semi-annually kaya divided by 2. So what is the present amount? This is 15,000 okay, divided by 0.0808. Compounded semi-annually divided by 2. So you have that as 371,287.13. So this will be the present amount. So check natin sa choices for item number 13. So we have that as 371,287.13. Ay letter C tayo kay problem number 13. Okay, for item number 14, this is our first example for depreciation. And our first method of depreciation, this is the straight line method. So for straight line method, okay, let's have its concept. Okay, for easier analysis, gawa lang tayo ng diagram. So let's say we have that is at a time is equal to 0. Okay, the value of a property is equal to FC, or that is the first cost. So as time goes by, so habang nagagamit yung property or habang naluluma yung property, so bumabagsak yung kanyang amount. And okay, at its useful life end, ay ang maiiwan na amount niya is the SB, the scrap value or the salvage value. And the total amount deducted is the depreciation at N. So we have that as D sub N. So in most cases, when it comes to depreciation problem, laging tinatanong yung mga amount dito sa gitna. Okay, so dito we have that is at time is equal to R. So we'll be having the depreciation at time R, D sub R, and yung kanyang book value at time R. So we have that as B sub R or the book value R. So tingnan lang natin kapag straight line method, ang gawin nyo lang dito is ratio and proportion of similar triangles. So yung triangle natin, yung nasa taas. So this is okay, yung time na to is R. Well, from 0 to N, Okay, for 0 to n naman, ito naman yung n. So, focus lang tayo dito sa kay triangles natin dito sa taas. So, ratio and proportion of similar triangles. So, we have that as the d sub r is 2r is equal to kay the d sub n is 2 n. O, yun lang naman. So, paano ba natin ikinocompute yung d sub n? So, basically, okay, parang i-compare lang natin yung mga heights ng mga vertical lines natin. Ang first cos ay equal lang sa d sub n plus the salvage value. Kumbaga, yung height na to is the same as this height. Or pwede rin na yung ating first cos ay equal sa yung height na to. Kaya d sub r plus the book value r. We have the d sub r plus ay book value r. So, ito yung mga parang basic ideas or equations na gagamitin natin kapag magiging formula-based yung solution natin for high straight line method. Okay, so let's have problem number 14. So, a lot costing 3 million pesos has a salvage value of 0.1 million. It can be used for 5,000 hours in its entire life. Find the book value after using 1,000 hours. So, list down lang natin ulit yung mga given. So, ang kanyang first cost is equal to 3 million. Okay, tapos, yung kanyang salvage value, we have the SOB is equal to 0.1 million. So, we have that as 0.1 million or basically, we can have it as 100,000 pesos. So, yung kanyang useful life N is equal to 5,000 hours. So, ang hinahanap natin dito is find the book value after using it for 1,000 hours. So, yung value ng R natin is equal to 1,000 hours. Okay, so when it comes to the straight line method, okay, so pwede kayong gumamit ng mga formula. Or pwede rin naman natin gamitin yung mode stat ng ating calculator. So, yun na lang muna yung ipapakita ko for this discussion. So, for the straight line method, ay mode 3 tayo, or that is the mode stat. Okay, so again, this is applicable only for the straight line method of depreciation. So, mode 3. So, yun yung mode 3 tayo, number 3. So, lalabas yung mga options. So, piliin nyo yung for straight line method, it is a linear number number 2. So, mode 3, 2 kapag straight line method. So, number 2 tayo, yun, lalabas yung dalawang columns natin. Yung columns ng X and Y. Yung X is for the time, pwedeng sabihin natin a year, or pwedeng, basta in terms of time. Yung Y naman natin is in terms of the first cost, salvage value, or ang nakocompute kasi dito is the book values. Yun, maglagay lang tayo ng two pairs of data. That is, at time is equal to zero, ang amount ng property is the first cost. Okay, which is, sa given natin, ang ating first cost is 3 million. Tapos, yung next set is N. Useful life niya is, according sa problem, given na 5,000 hours. After useful life, ang naiwan is the salvage value, which is equal to 100,000. So, ito yung pattern kapag straight line method. Okay, mag-input na tayo ng data. We have that as 0 equals, then 5,000 hours equals. Then, lagay lang natin yung data. First cost, we have that as 3 million. Then, salvage value is 100,000. Yan. So, after natin maglagay ng data, press AC. Yan. So, press ko lang yung AC. Tapos, di ba ang hinahanap natin is the book value at 1,000 hours. So, i-type niyo sa calculator, 1,000. So, this is 1,000. Then, shift number 1. Or, that is basically shift stat Okay, so shift number 1, then number 5 tayo. Okay, so number 5, ito yung regression sa calculator. So number 5, tapos number 5 ulit, ito naman yung y hat. Okay, so ito yung procedure. AC 1000 shift 1, number 5 regression, number 5 y hat. So number 5. So dapat yun, yung nasa screen ng calculator natin is 1000 of y hat. That is basically our book value R. So take note, okay, ang nakocompute natin dito is book value. So we have that, then press equals lang. So we have that as ay 2 million. This is now 2,400,000. Yan, 2,420,000. Tama ba? 420,000. Tama ba? Check ko lang. So we have that as ay 2,420,000. So let us check sa ating choices. If we have 2,420,000, so that will be okay, problem number 14. And this is letter C, 2,420,000. So again, kapag straight line method, pwede kayong gumamit ng formula base, or pwede naman yung mas recommended, calculator base or Caltech. Okay, so we proceed sa number 15. So this is another method for depreciation. Okay, this is the sinking fund method. So konting intro lang ulit. Okay, so for our diagram, again, at time is equal to 0, the amount is FC. So habang tumatagal, ay bumababa yung value ng isang property, okay, after its useful life, and ang amount na naiwan is salvage value. Okay, when it comes to the sinking fund method, yung graph niya is a curve. For a reason, ay nag-i-interest yung depreciation. Meron tayong uniform depreciation at the same time nag-i-interest siya. And yung kanilang future amount is ida d sub n. So again, when it comes to depreciation problems, ang laging hinahanap is yung amounts, yung mga amounts natin dito sa gitna. That is at time is equal to r. So we have the d sub r at saka yung book value r. So, paano natin i-compute yung D sub R or the book value R? So, when it comes to the sinking fund method, okay, number one requirement, dapat given yung, okay, dapat given ito, yung effective rate of interest. Or yun din yung clue ninyo kung kailan gagamitin yung sinking fund method. For example, hindi siya nagsabi ng method na gagamitin, pero given yung effective rate, so which means, okay, sinking fund method siya. Okay, i-recall lang nyo class yung formula ng future amount ng annuity. The future amount is equal to the annuity, okay, multiplied by the 1 plus I raised to N minus 1. Okay, this is okay, divided by I. So, take note na ang sinking fund method is simply okay, a concept ng annuity. Kaya lang dito, okay, iba lang yung ginagamit. So, instead na future amount F, yun yung future amount ng mga depreciation. We have the D sub N. Tapos, yung ating annual depreciation, yung small d, that is your annuity. Then, multiplied by, we have the 1 plus I raised to N minus 1. Okay, minus 1 divided by I. Ayan. So, yun lang naman yung nagpalit. Okay, so again, this is the same as the annuity. So, paano naman natin i-compute yung d sub n? Ito yung formula, that is the future amount at time n. Paano naman yung d sub r? So, for the d sub r, yun, magpapalit lang naman tayo ng subscript at saka yung superscript. We have d sub r is equal to the uniform depreciation d, okay, multiplied by 1 plus I raised to R minus 1 divided by I. So when it comes to depreciation methods, unfortunately, itong si sinking fund method, siya lang yung method na walang Caltech. Kaya no choice kayo, dapat ay formula-based yung solution. Okay, so mag-focus lang tayo sa dalawang formula na to. Ano yung common sa kanila? Ang common sa kanila is the uniform depreciation, D. So, paano natin kukunin or paano natin i-equate yung dalawa? So, equate lang natin sa uniform depreciation, D. So, we have that as the D is equal to, ay galing dito sa unang equation. Okay, we have that as the D sub N multiplied by I cross multiplication, then divided by 1 plus I raised to N minus 1. Yun yung equivalent ng uniform depreciation from the first equation. What about from the second naman, yung D sub R? Equal to, the D sub R, then multiplied by I divided by 1 plus I raised to R minus 1. So dito you can cancel out yung I. Yun naman yung relation ng dalawang values. Okay, the D sub N, ay the D sub R. So hopefully hindi mahirap i-memorize yun for a reason. Magkaiba lang naman. Subscript lang is N, exponent is N. Subscript is R, exponent is R. Parang ratio N, proportion lang. Okay, let's have problem number 15. Sabi niya class, so we have a dump truck was bought for 300,000 pesos 6 years ago. It will have a salvage value of 30,000 pesos 4 years from now. What is the book value now if sinking fund method of depreciation is used at 6% interest okay, per year? So, naghahanap tayo ng book value. So, sulat lang muna natin yung mga given. So, now is 6. R is equal to 6 kasi sabi niya, ay, a truck was bought 6 years ago. So, R is equal to 6. Yun yung ating present time. Tapos, sabi niya dito, 4 years from now. Okay, so we have 4 years from now. So, basically, we have that as 6 plus 4. Okay, the value of N is equal to 10. Okay? Tapos, yan. I-list down lang uli natin yung ating mga given. So you have the first cost is equal to 300,000 pesos and yung kanyang salvage value is equal to 30,000 pesos. Tapos effective rate of interest is 6%. Ayan. So hinahanap natin kasi dito is book value R or that is basically book value number 6. Yung book value now, present book value. So, kunin muna natin yung D sub R or the D sub 6. So, pero yun, gagamitin natin yung D sub N. Based sa ating diagram, paano kunin yung D sub N? Di ba, nailagay ko na rin ito kanina. Pareho lang naman for all depreciation method. Okay, comparison of heights lang. Yung ating height na to is the same as yung height sa kabila. So, we have that as the first cost is equal to the D sub N plus the salvage value. So, basically, yung ating D sub N ay equal sa first cost minus SB. Okay, computing for that value, we have D sub N is equal to first cost na 300,000 ay minus the 30,000. So, D sub N is equal to 270,000. Okay, using that value of D sub N, makuha natin yung the D sub 6. Para masolve kasi natin yung book value number 6, kailangan natin ng D sub 6. Okay, so mag-substitute lang tayo. Okay, sa equation na to. Okay, again, what is our D sub N? So, ang ating D sub N is equal to 270,000. This is divided by 1 plus. Effective rate is 0.06. Useful life nito is 10 minus 1. Is equal to D sub R, or that is our D6, Okay, divided by 1 plus 0.06. So, iba lang yung exponent, raised to 6 minus 1. So, let's have, okay, RD sub 6. Okay, this is 270, nasa mode stat pa rin pala. Number 1, we have 270,000. Okay, this is divided by 1 plus 0.06, okay, raised to 10. Okay, minus 1. Okay, is equal to, okay, alpha x, this is divided by 1 plus the 0.06, okay, raised to 6, okay, minus 1. Shift solve na lang ako. So, we have that as 142,884.86. Okay, 142,884.86. So, ito na ba yung sagot natin? Okay, so again, kung ibabasahin natin maigi yung problem, ang inahanap is, okay, the book value. Book value number 6. Paano mag-compute ng book value? So, dito, yun, i-compare lang uli natin yung mga heights, di ba? Ito yung first cost, yung height na to is the same as this height. So, for our equation, ay first cost is equal to the d sub r plus the book value r. Or basically, ang book value r is equal to the first cost minus the d sub r. So, again, unfortunately, ay ito lang yung method na walang Caltech, ay the sinking fund method. So, computing for book value number 6, ano yung ating first cost? We have that as 300,000 minus RD sub R or the D sub 6. Okay, minus 142,884.86. So, book value number 6 natin is now equal to, okay, this value, ibawas natin yan sa 300,000. So, 300,000 minus the answer. 115.14. So this will be our answer. Book value number 6. Therefore, sa number 15, ang sagot natin is letter B. So, sa yung book value number 6, sa yung required. So, nandito pala yung ating D sub 6, pero hindi kasi siya yung sagot. Or hindi siya yung required. So, letter B yung sagot natin dyan. So, again, this is number 15, our example for the sinking fund method.